In recent times, I noticed, while staring out of the windows in my apartment, that I really do not like the winter season. One of the reasons might be that I'm already planning an automated greenhouse for my garden, in which I, for example, will be measuring the humidity of the air and earth in order to determine when to water the plants. For such a watering system, I would of course require some sort of water pump. And that was the moment I started searching for 12 volts DC one on Amazon. But as you can see, the selection is not that huge, and thus I was more or less forced to go with this 12 volt 6W one, which according to its product description can do 8 liters per minute. But after receiving the pump and having a closer look at it, I realized that its mechanical construction is rather simple. And since the company Trinamic Motion Control, who are not only the sponsor of this video, but also produce all kinds of awesome ICs for motor control, recently sent me a brand new prototype motor controller board along with a powerful BLDC motor, I will try to create my own 3D printed water pump with it in this episode of DIY or Buy, so that at the end we can determine whether it makes sense to DIY a water pump, or whether we should stick to the commercial solution instead. Let's get started! First off, we need to understand how the small commercial water pump works in order to create a bigger replica. So I added adapters onto the two threads of the pump and then used some sealing tape in order to make everything watertight, so that in the end I could push two 12mm wide PVC tubes onto them. At this point I hooked up the power wires to a 12V power source, and as you would expect, the motor draws current and something started rotating inside the pump. That means it was time for me to get two bowls and fill one up with exactly 1 liter of water. But the problem was that no matter which PVC tube I placed in the water, the pump never started transporting the water on its own. The reason is that this kind of water pump is not a self-priming pump, which means I have to use some of my own energy in order to get the water to the pump. But afterwards it does its job without a problem. And it seems like the water can only enter this way and exit this way. Now after doing some more or less scientific measurements, I calculated an average flow rate of around 10 liters per minute, at an average power draw of around 7.4 watts, which means that the product description was pretty accurate. And with those tests out of the way, I removed the adapters as well as the screws that held the pump together. After removing the front piece, we can see a wheel which was being turned by the utilized motor. So what happens is that the water enters through this hole and fills up the entire space around the wheel. And while the wheel is spinning, it accelerates the water which flows radially outwards and into a hole where it exits. Because of this functional principle, this kind of pump is known as a centrifugal pump, and theoretically we should be able to 3D print the mechanical parts for it. But while I was getting close to finishing the first sketch of my own centrifugal pump, I noticed that the user Adolf over at Thingiverse already created a pretty promising looking design for a bigger one. Of course, I would not require its motor mount, since I will be using a different motor than him, but the main components of the pump looked very nice. So I downloaded its files and imported them into the Prusa slicer software, in which I obviously sliced them. Afterwards, I 3D printed each model with my Prusa i3 Mark III 3D printer, for which I used orange PETG filament to give the pump a bit more mechanical strength. As soon as the three parts were printed, I removed all of their support material, which was a bit more difficult than I expected. But nevertheless, as soon as that was done, we can already see how the parts will fit together later on. So now we need to attach the motor in a way to constantly turn the wheel. For that, I firstly added a motor shaft coupler to the wheel, which coincidentally also perfectly fits onto the motor shafts. So the only measurement I required was the height of the wheel shafts, which was around 6 cm. And with the measurement and through the help of the datasheet of the motor and its given mechanical dimensions, I created a fitting motor mount in 123D design. The next step was to obviously 3D print it, which turned out just fine. Now to finish the mechanical setup, I firstly created a circle shape with silicone tape, which I placed inside the ball bearing cavity, into which I then placed an ice cold ball bearing that got hammered into position. Next, I added another sealing on the inside for the wheel, then poked a hole through both of them, and thus finally added the wheel to the system. At this point, I started cutting up and adding the silicone tape all around the pump's edges, which in retrospective was a dumb idea, so I will not waste time talking about that, and just say that the pump was completed after using M3 screws to close everything up. Next, I got myself a wooden board, onto which I firstly marked the pump's mounting holes in order to drill them and then to secure the pump to it with M4 bolts and nuts. Afterwards, I fixed the motor inside the motor mount and added the motor shaft coupler to the wheel and the motor shafts in order to determine a suitable position for the motor mount. After then marking its mounting holes and drilling them as well, I secured it with M4 bolts and nuts to the wooden board, and just like that, the mechanical construction should have been complete. But at this point, I noticed that the silicone tape inside the pump hinders the movement of the wheel. So I was more or less forced to remove most of it, and instead create a watertight seal with good old hot glue. Now finally, we need to drive the BLDC motor, for which we could use a generic ESC, but like already mentioned, Dynamics sent me this new DOC5 prototype board that combines a RISC-V MCU with a motion controller, which is pretty unique. You can find more information about the board on the internet. But for now, let me tell you that you can configure it with the provided TMC IDE or program it directly through the Eclipse software. I also need to tell you that I did not write this code, since as you can see, it is fairly complex and I'm more of a hardware guy. Instead, a Dynamics employee made it for me, and its function is to basically drive the motor with an adjustable RPM according to the position of a potentiometer. So after programming the board, I hooked up all of the required wires and components and powered everything with a 12-volt power source. As you can see, the motor rotates without any problems, and it seems like our pump is ready for some water. That is why I added 32mm wide hoses to the entry and exit hole, and once again got myself 2 bolts. But I realized fairly quickly that this big pump in combination with the big tubes does not work well with my small bolts. So I was forced to move to the bathtub, in which the DIY pump showcased that it was desperately trying to pump water. But as soon as I increased the RPM to a certain degree, something went terribly wrong. It seems like the PETG material is not strong enough for the wheel shafts, and since I was not even going with half power, it seems like 3D printing a big and powerful water pump is not such a good idea. Of course, there also does exist a promising looking 3D printed micro water pump on Thingiverse, whose material will not experience such big forces in comparison to my big 3D printed pump. But then again, if I want a small DC water pump, then I would go with the commercial solution. So according to my experiments and my own personal opinion, I have to say that buy is this time like most of the time, the winner. But what do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hitting the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!